Related to global climate change issues, United Nations held Paris Conference on Climate Change, which resulted in an agreement to limit global warming to less than 2 degrees Celsius. In addition, United Nations has also compiled 17 Sustainable Development Goals as a Global Development Agreement, which, among others, targets two goals, namely affordable and clean energy, as well as climate action. As consequences of Indonesia's commitment to Paris Agreement and Sustainable Development Goals, the Indonesian government has issued government regulation which targeting a renewable energy mix of 23% by 2025 and 31% by 2050. Pertamina is Indonesia's largest state-owned enterprise, which carries out integrated energy business and operation from upstream to downstream and serves energy need of one of the world's largest population. To support the aspiration of the global community in reducing greenhouse gases emissions, Pertamina implements environmental, social, and governance aspects in every line of business and operation. It also accelerates the energy transition through Pertamina Energy Transition Master Plan Program, consists of 8 initiatives. First, Green Refinery. Pertamina has built Green Refinery in Pelaju, Dumai, and Cilacap. Second, bioenergy. Pertamina is currently developing biomass to bioethanol project based on the best available technologies. Third, geothermal. Pertamina monetizes its geothermal assets via independent power producers to develop 1.3 gigawatt of geothermal projects. Fourth, green hydrogen. Pertamina has started the utilization of green hydrogen in Indonesia. Green hydrogen potential from Pertamina's geothermal field, total potential 8,600 kg hydrogen per day. Fifth, electric vehicle battery and energy storage system. Pertamina has set up battery manufacturing via partnership with battery technology providers and also has set up charging infrastructure for electric two-wheel vehicle, battery-to-battery swap, and electric four-wheel vehicle. 6. Gasification. Pertamina optimizes gas utilization for transportation, household, as well as industry and power across Indonesia. 7th, new and renewable energy. Pertamina has developed domestic solar-based independent power producers in high solar irradiation areas and also has entered into strategic partnership for solar cell manufacturing. Lastly, circular carbon economy. Pertamina plans to apply carbon, capture, use, and storage, or CCUS, in two areas, enhanced oil recovery and enhanced gas recovery in its production fields. Furthermore, apart from having the Pertamina Energy Transition Master Plan Program, Pertamina always harmonizes its business and operations with the progress of society and the progress of the environment through corporate social responsibility programs in education, health, environmental preservation, and economic empowerment. The President of the Republic of Indonesia, Joko Widodo, appreciates Pertamina's aggressive efforts in energy transition as well as in strengthening the nation's energy resilience.
Mengapa kita harus melakukan percepatan implementasi program biodiesel? Ada tiga alasan. Yang pertama, kita berusaha untuk mencari sumber-sumber energi baru terbarukan. Energi terbarukan. Dan kita harus melepaskan diri dari ketergantungan pada energi fosil yang tak sadar suatu saat pasti akan habis. Pengembangan energi baru terbarukan juga membuktikan komitmen kita untuk menjaga planet bumi, menjaga energi bersih dengan menurunkan emisi gas karbon dan untuk meningkatkan kualitas lingkungan.
Tahun 2019 kita sudah berhasil memproduksi dan menggunakan B20, dan tahun ini kita mulai dengan B30, sehingga kita mampu menekan nilai impor minyak kita di tahun 2019. Pertamina bekerjasama dengan para peneliti telah berhasil menciptakan katalis untuk pembuatan D100, yaitu bahan bakar diesel yang 100% dibuat dari minyak kelapa sawit yang sedang uji produksi di 2 kilang minyak kita. Ini akan menyerap minimal 1 juta ton sawit produksi petani untuk kapasitas produksi 20 ribu barel per hari. Hilirisasi bahan mentah yang lain juga terus dilakukan secara besar-besaran. Batu bara diolah untuk menjadi metanol dan gas. Beberapa kilang dibangun untuk mengolah minyak mentah menjadi minyak jadi dan sekaligus menjadi penggerak industri petrokimia yang memasok produk industri hilir bernilai tambah tinggi.
We are enthusiastic at unleashing various potentials, accelerating progress, and achieving shared goals. Be a part of better future, energizing sustainable future, energizing you.